A new volcanic eruption just began at the Kilauea Volcano in Hawaii, ending a nearly one-month-long absence in eruptive activity on the Big Island, as shown in this video courtesy of the Two Pineapples YouTube channel. This new eruption followed a gradual inflation of Kilauea's summit, which had been ongoing since November 28th of 2022. Since this signaled the movement of magma into the volcano, this activity generated an earthquake swarm of 25 earthquakes on December 30th of 2022. An increased rate of ground deformation and earthquake activity followed on January 5th of 2023, causing Kilauea's alert level to be raised from yellow to orange. Then, at 4:34 p.m. local time on January 5th on the Big Island of Hawaii, a singular vent erupted, creating a fountain of lava. A second vent subsequently erupted around an hour later, and together these two vents quickly covered much of the crater floor. As of 4 hours into the eruption, lava had filled the active crater to a depth of approximately 10 meters or 32 feet. This can be best displayed via comparison to a stationary feature, which is a conical structure known as a hornito. Note how the lava level quickly rises around it. Luckily, this eruption has so far remained within Kilauea's summit caldera and for now seems likely to remain there. If you are unsure of the locations I am describing, here is some overview. The Kilauea volcano is the youngest of four active volcanoes on the Big Island, which have each produced eruptions during the Holocene epoch. The edifice of the Kilauea volcano is located on the southeastern flank of the more voluminous Mauna Loa volcano, with Kilauea's outline being displayed in red. Although Kilauea's current eruption is confined to within its summit caldera, past eruptions have also taken place on the volcano's flanks through two rift zones. These rift zones, known as the southwest and east rift zones, have produced a variety of recent eruptions. However, generally speaking, before a rift zone eruption occurs, there is generally warning signs beforehand. Kilauea's caldera did not form through primarily explosive activity, but rather through the draining of its magma chamber by flank rift zone eruptions, which caused the overlying rock and the summit region of the volcano to collapse downwards and fill the empty space. The latest example of a caldera collapse at Kilauea occurred in 2018, which not only expanded and deepened a section of the caldera, but also created a down-dropped block. Lava is currently erupting within a crater within the down-dropped block, which is itself within Kilauea's summit caldera. The erupted molten rock is highly likely to remain there and would only be a cause for concern if the lava lake suddenly started rapidly draining away to a more distant location. And due to the nature of Kilauea, its current eruption is unlikely, at least for the moment, to have any explosive component to it. What is uncertain is how long the brand new eruption will last. Eruptions from Kilauea have lasted anywhere from less than 24 hours in length to several weeks, months, or, on rare occasions, years, and on even rarer occasions, several decades in length. Regardless, Kilauea's lava lake will likely continue to get deeper, causing the surface level to rise and get closer to the down-dropped block. Although unlikely to occur during the current ongoing eruption, this may eventually bring Kilauea's active crater to its 2018 elevation before the caldera collapse occurred. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.